really good sprint doubles, Makai Williams of Oregon and Makai Harris of Texas. Harris wind aided at that Texas Tech track 993 and then 1972. Makai Williams was 993 20.01. Which one do you think was better?
I mean, Makai Harris. He ran 19.7, dude. Like, come on. Makai Harris? I know it's at altitude and it's a lot more windy. But Makai Harris.
3.8.
Definitely. First of all, who has a better way of saying spelling their name? And what happened with Makai Harris with the way they spell that name? Because let me tell you, that looks like a typo. I don't know about you, but M-I-C-A-I-A-H looks like a typo. Feels like there's an extra I and an extra A somewhere in there. They need to fix the way he spells his name. I like the way the man from Oregon spells his name as opposed to the man from Texas. No, but 1972 and a 200. That's, again, it was windy and it's at altitude, but that's what Olympic champions run. I mean, that's what Noah Lyles just ran, you know? So I think that 19.7 from Harris definitely puts it over the top. And should Harris be a sleeper for making the world team the 200 now?
I think he was always in the mix. Last couple of years, we talked about him since 2019. I think each of them impressed in their non-focus event. So for Harris, it was dropping down to the 100 and running that fast. I mean, the 19.7, yeah, it's like, whoa. But I knew, you know, when you factor in the wind and the altitude, it's like, all right, that's in line with what this guy is capable of. Makai Williams, I thought it was impressive to run 20.0 in the 200. We know how good he is in the 100. His start is just still, it's just one of the most entertaining things to watch in track and field. Makai Williams, he gets out so quickly. So I don't know how I would. I know Burnett pulled up in that 100 and then in the SEC 100. I don't know if anybody really distinguished themselves. So I think coming out of this weekend, you look at Makai Williams being the 100-meter favorite.
When you look at World Athletics, they find a way to kind of calculate wind-aided marks and headwind marks to kind of just rank them. Right now, Knighton's 19.49 is number one. Number two is Lyles' 19.72. Number three is Fred Curley's 19.75. Number four is Michael Norman's 1983. And then number five in the freaking world is Makai Harris's 1972. So
are they putting altitude in there too?
Yeah. They keep checking all that. Results score. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's calculated.
No, he's a great 200. He's a great 200 meter runner, and I would put him in there with Bowling and Fanbele in the 200. That's what I'm saying. Each guy going and excelling though in their off distance, the 100 or 200 was a good sign for both of them. Do you agree that Williams is the 100 favorite now?
Yeah, Williams is the 100 favorite, but I wanted to change this conversation to Harris might be making one of the hardest world teams to make, which is the men's 200 for the U.S. And I think
he's in the mix. I don't. Okay, who's he beating? Is he beating Knighton?
No.
Is he beating Curley?
No.
Okay. So then there's one spot left. So it's
you get the third spot.
Him versus everybody. Yeah, it's just long odds because you have one spot left.
If you can I can see him beating Kenny Bednarik right now. Bednarik hasn't done anything.
Okay. Well, it's everybody though. It's not just him. Because when you take away two of the three spots already, Lyles has a bye, remember. That's challenging. If you're already saying two of the three are spoken for, then it's just one other person that needs to do it.
I would take Harris over a field of Bednarik, Coleman, Isaiah Young, Kyrie King, Cravon Gillespie, just all those other sprinters I can think of in that 200. The NCAA athletes.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.